Welcome to JR TV. Now we are inserting this beautiful floral plant stem into aloe vera leaf on dorsal surface vertically, not in inclining, because this if we can insert this this stem into dragon plant vertically, there will be chances of there won't be any space between the dorsal surface of aloe vera leaf and this inserting branch of a floral branch. So definitely the plants both will share the this floral floral cutting of this stem will be inserted into aloe vera plant, and the aloe vera plant first something is going on my dorsal surface of leaf. Some foreign material inserted into my dorsal surface, leaf pulp, and immediately there will be physical reaction, there will be chemical reaction and a physical change, because we are probing one live floral plant vertically into the dorsal surface of this aloe vera plant, and it will observe for 3-4 days. The aloe vera plant will observe for 3-4 days. After that, plant will slowly absorb nutrients and vitamins and minerals and metals directly from the stem of this floral plant. Slowly the floral plant the baby roots will germinate from the tips of this floral stem, and it will survive on the dorsal surface of this aloe vera plant. So we have to create there should not be too much sunlight. Actually this practical should be done in a shaded atmosphere, means too much of sunlight is not preferable, because there will be dehydration of cutting plants into the aloe vera surface. So all cuttings should not dehydrate from the excess atmospheric sunlight, and in this winter there will be dry weather in daytime, so there won't be any moisture. Because of dry weather, the inserted plant stem cutting will the leaves will dry up, and the stem also will dry up, and there will be necrosis of the inserting stem. The plant will die eventually. So we have to create shaded by a big leaf. We can cover the inserted plant by giving shadow, by shade, because we have to protect from the abnormal warm heat from sunlight. So we successfully inserted this plant into aloe vera stem, and definitely our practical will be 100% success, because the solution or viscid viscous liquid in the leaf of a aloe vera plant is very medicinal value, and it is having a water content, it is having a viscous, because the in unfavorable climatic conditions like coming summer, the liquid won't evaporate or the plant won't dehydrate because of high viscosity plant secretions in the leaf of a aloe vera plant. So there will be chances of exchange of minerals or metals or proteins or essential elements and nutrients from viscous liquid from aloe vera plant. So this will be 100% successful in coming days, and definitely we will do practicals because the time is very precious, the space is also very precious in metro cities and cosmopolitan cities. The space is so precious, so we have to utilize the precious space into a meaningful and productive yield or productive germination of this latest biotechnology from plant upon plants. One plant we can grow five plants on the stems of different same species of same characters of plants under one roof. So we have inserted this plants on this dorsal surface and this dorsal surface. So we will see after 10 to 15 days if there is any drastic change or any necrosis or any inserted plant dryness or leaf fall or any germination of small leaves will be the positive sign for sustainability on plant upon the plant. So this is the practically we can implement because the plants will interdependent on each other, because some plants will xerophytic, some plants will hydrophytic, because in stagnated water the plants will grow vigorously and aggressively. Some plants will grow in dry climatic conditions, some plants will grow in xerophytic conditions like cactus family, dragon plant and this aloe vera plant and this nagajamudu, brahmajamudu and other cactus family, because so many spicules all over the surface of this plants, 360 degrees the spicules will projected out, and the spicules on the plant is a self defense mechanism, so animals can't bite. The sheep, the buffaloes or the cows, the lamb or the wild pig or rabbits won't chew because the spicules will penetrate into the palate, soft palate, or the cheeks will pierce, the spicules will penetrate into cheeks, and there will be lot of inconvenience to masticate or grind or chew this cactus family plants. So touch me not, don't bite. If you bite, I will penetrate into your soft palate or hard palate or buccal mucosa or onto the dorsum of tongue. So the spicules will give cautious precautionary sign for these wild animals. So cactus family is very on the practicals on cactus family xerophytic plants is 100% successful because the cactus in unfavorable climatic conditions also the cactus will sustain for years together and there is no death for this cactus family because if we can do practicals on cactus family plant the inserting plant the parasitic plant or the saprophytic plant also will grow eventually because it will save the plant because some foreign material or some foreign particle or something is happening on my dorsal surface or ventral surface of this leaf so immediately the aloe vera plant will release some toxins this inserted plant will dissolve will minimize the toxins and there will be mutual understanding because you win and I also win win-win situation so the plants never struggle like human beings because human beings and animals wild animals lions cheetah and human beings monkeys and gorillas and pet animals and dogs and rats and snakes these struggle for existence they will fight each other even human beings fight each other and but plants never they are down to earth because one plant never fight with other plant but there will be some drastic change in the plant itself and same because the inserted plant also same family so of different species so the aloe vera plant will allow the different species to grow healthy on the dorsal surface or ventral surface of this aloe vera plant so the plant upon the plant is latest technology we are introducing and we are doing research and development on aloe vera plant definitely it will be 100% success because the bryophyllum the brahmakamalam plant successfully sharing the nutrients from the aloe vera plant and this dragon plant also so this will be 100% success and we should do practicals because we do practicals thank you so much for watching JRTV signing off click welcome to JRTV now we are inserting this vomitala aku because this is a vegetative propagation meer we are inserting this this leaf onto the dorsal surface of this this plant So beautifully we have operated this insertion of this leaf onto the dorsal surface of aloe vera plant because if we give small hole onto the dorsal surface of aloe vera leaf we can push any leaf onto the dorsal or ventral surface of aloe vera leaf. So we can penetrate this stalk of this medicated leaf onto the dorsal surface or ventral surface of aloe vera leaf. So there will be drastic change in the leaf, and there will be some reaction, physical or chemical reaction will going on, and after week to 10 days there will be exchange of fluids from one plant to another inserted plant, and definitely there will be growth, there will be perfect comfortable exchange of fluids, exchange of nutrients, exchange of minerals, exchange of metals, exchange of vitamins, there will be slowly, and so this is the for medical clinical studies, for in medical there will be clinical studies like we will use pet animals like moose, rat and rabbit and monkey and some other mammalian family. But in plants, the aloe vera plant is the best of best for doing a practicals on aloe vera plant, because the liquid or viscid and consistency, the high consistency of this solution will allow germination of any species plant onto the dorsal surface of this aloe vera plant. So this is the beauty of because if we fragment the leaf of aloe vera into many cuttings, and if we plant it, definitely each fragment will grow very healthy aloe vera plant. So we have inserted this medicated leaf onto the dorsal surface of this aloe vera plant, and we will facilitate there will be shaded net so that the inserted leaf won't dry up, dehydrate, and it won't lose the color and consistency and the softness, and even it won't dry up, and there will be proliferation of this leaf. So this Vamutala plant, so that there will be hybrid medicinal value, because the aloe vera plant having its own Ayurvedic properties, and this Vamutala leaf also having so much aromatic and carminative, and it will arrest the upper respiratory tract infections in the throat area, and tonsillar infections, and nasal congestion, and it will kill streptococcus and staphylococcus bacterial infections in throat area and laryngeal area and nasopharyngeal junction, and so it is highly it is having so much of medicinal value in this medicinal plants. So this leaf after 10 to 15 days by putting this shaded atmosphere and pouring water and nutrients and minerals and vermicompost and by day 1 to 15 days we have to take report what is the mother plant leaf, aloe vera leaf condition. Is there any necrosis or change in color or change in color into yellow color or any leaf necrosis or any dryness of leaf or any color change or any wrinkles onto the leaf or any loss of stiffness of leaf or any consistency leaf leaf become nervous like that, any problem also we have to check. So this is the beauty of plant upon the plant growing technology, because the space is very precious, the time is very precious, the nature is so precious, and the earth and its derivatives are very most more precious. So this inserting different plants onto the dorsal or ventral surface of aloe vera plant, we will get outstanding results, outstanding experimental results on open terrace, and definitely the plant will grow. There will be competition, healthy competition between the parasitic plant and the mother plant of this aloe vera, and the plants will grow competition of 100 meters running competition. So this is the beauty of growing medicinal plants on a medicinal plant. So this is the we are doing tremendous experiments on this medicinal plant.